Hello friends, in today's lecture we will discuss Caries Index for permanent teeth. Most commonly DMFT or DMFS index is used for caries, assessment of caries in permanent teeth. The caries indices most commonly used for assessment of caries in permanent teeth are decayed, missing and filled teeth index, and another one is the decayed, missing, filled surface index. This DMFT DMFS index was given by Klein, Palmer and Knudsen in 1938. In this index, the teeth examined are all permanent teeth. Previously only 28 teeth were examined. Third molars were excluded, but as per the WHO modification in 1986, third molars are also included in this caries index. Excluded teeth are deciduous teeth, unerupted teeth, supernumerary teeth and congenitally missing teeth. These teeth are not examined in this index. The instruments required for recording this index are mouth mirror and explorer. The scoring criteria for decayed, missing and filled teeth is as follows. For decayed or carious teeth, clinically visible cavitated or non-cavitated carious lesion, if present, it will be recorded. Only carious cavities are considered as decayed. The initial lesions like chalky spots or stained fissures are not considered as decayed. This was according to the WHO modification 1986. The explorer tip catch in demineralized tooth structure is also considered as a decayed structure or a decayed tooth. Tooth with temporary restorations, which are not restored with the permanent restorations, will also be considered as a decayed tooth. This was again as per the WHO modification in 1986. And the tooth with permanent restoration having recurrent caries is also included under the decayed category of tooth. For considering the tooth as a missing tooth, the criteria is missing permanent teeth due to decay, badly carious teeth indicated for extraction are also considered as missing teeth. The teeth which are not considered as missing are tooth extracted for orthodontic reason, unerupted permanent teeth and tooth lost in accident. This will not be considered as a missing teeth. Filled teeth are considered only those teeth with permanent restorations without recurrent caries. So this will be considered as a filled teeth. This index, decayed missing filled teeth and decayed missing filled surface index, was modified by WHO in 1986, and the three modifications which were given are: third molars are included, number two, temporary restorations are considered as decayed, and number three, only carious cavities are considered as decayed. The initial lesions like chalky spots or stained fissures are not considered as decayed teeth. For recording this index, the diagram is as shown here. All the teeth are considered from all the four quadrants, and for recording the decayed missing filled teeth, total number of decayed, missing and filled teeth are counted. So from each quadrant we will mark the teeth which are decayed, missing, filled. Then we will see how many teeth are decayed, how many teeth are filled and how many teeth are missing, and then we will add all these three to get the DMFT score. Similarly, for recording the DMFS index, that is decayed, missing and filled surfaces, we will record all the surfaces which are decayed or missing or filled. So in anterior teeth, that is central incisor, lateral incisor and canine, four surfaces will be considered, that is the mesial, distal, labial and lingual or palatal. And for posterior teeth, the five surfaces will be considered, that is occlusal, mesial, distal, labial and lingual. So in this way, we will calculate all the decayed surfaces, then all the missing surfaces, then all filled surfaces, and then we will add all these surfaces to get the DMFS, that is decayed missing filled surface score. So actually the similarity between these two indices is that in DMFT index we are recording only the total number of teeth which are decayed, missing or filled, and in DMFS index we will be recording total number of decayed, missing and filled surfaces of these teeth. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you understood the topic. If you have any doubt, you can mention in the comment section below. Please subscribe to the channel for more such lectures and click on the bell icon to get notifications of newly uploaded videos. Thank you.